Good afternoon, viewer. I would like to share the word of God with us this afternoon about not worrying, because at this point in time, we are living in a very difficult time, and it is easy even to worry because of what we are going through. This coronavirus has put us in a corner, and sometimes we become so anxious. Even we were wondering what we shall eat and what we shall drink, what we shall wear, how are we going to take back our children to school if there is lockdown, or if we don't have, we are not allowed to go back to work. So it is possible now to be worried and be very anxious. But I want to encourage us with the word of God from the book of Matthew, chapter 6, from verse number 25, which says, I'm reading from the New King James Version. Therefore, I say, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, nor about your body, what you will put on. Is not life not more than food, and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds of the air, for they neither sow nor reap, nor gather into barns, yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not of more value than they? Which of you, by worrying, can add one cubit to his stature? So why do you worry about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin, and yet I say to you that even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. Now, if God so clothes the grass of the field, which today is and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, will he not much more clothe you, O you of little faith? Therefore, do not worry, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or what shall we wear? For after all, these things the Gentiles seek, for your heavenly Father knows that you need all these things. But seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added to you as well. Therefore, do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about its own things. Sufficient for the day is its own trouble. So the text that I have read, it actually is about worry. It is about anxiety. When we talk of anxiety, anxiety is fear and doubt about the future. And right now, we might be having a lot of fear, and even we doubt the future. But one thing I want to encourage us is that our God is in control. Even the things that we are hearing and we are seeing, it is not that God does not understand. He understands. We are the people who are limited, and we don't understand why he allows some of these things to happen, like the coronavirus that we are hearing of, and that is has scared us until now. We have closed our schools, our business are closed, and even we don't know the message that we are going to the updates that we are going to receive today. But one thing is sure is that there is God in heaven, and he knows and he understands what we go through every day. And if he has allowed this thing to happen, we may not understand. But what we know is that he is in control. And this afternoon he is telling us not to worry, for he is in control. And in fact, the Bible says in the book of Philippians that we should not be anxious of anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication we should make our request known to him. What we need to do is just to make our request, let him know, let us pray and tell God. We may not understand what is happening, but you understand. If there is anything that we have done, which we ought not to have done, Lord, forgive us and shorten this period because we are anxious. And after we have prayed, we thank him, because the Bible says we say with thanksgiving, we should make our request known to him. And even in Philippians chapter 4, verse number 7, he says, "At the peace of God that surpasses the understanding of men will keep our hearts and mind in Christ Jesus," because we need that peace of God that will keep our heart and mind, because fear will not add anything to us. Worry will not add anything to us. And that is why the Bible says we should not worry about the future. This does not mean we should be careless. No, we need not to be careless. We should be mindful and we should be hardworking, because God is a worker. But there are times that even our work, we will not yield anything, because the Bible says, unless the Lord builds the house, those that labor, they labor in vain. Unless the Lord watches over the city, even those that who keep watch, the watchmen who watch over the night, they do it in vain. And this we can see with this COVID-19. We have powerful men in the world, with all the machinery, with all the system, with all the leeches, and they have all the scientists. But you'll find even this corona virus fights its way to the palace. It fights its way even to the queen's place. And therefore, this shows that God is in control. And unless he builds the house, it is in vain. And therefore, this is calling us to involve God in all that we do. And that is even why the Bible says, the fool says, or try to convince himself in his heart, that there is no God. And that is why they live reckless life, because they think they have everything. But now, what we have seen, everybody is going to God. We only need God to come and arrest this virus. But I have come to encourage us this afternoon to tell us that, as the Bible says, we look at the birds of the air. They do not sow, they do not reap, they do not gather into barns, but the Heavenly Father feeds them. And I want to tell us, even this afternoon, because we believe in God, he is going to supply to our needs. He is going to take care of us. It is a call for us to go back to God, to wait on him. For the Bible says, those that wait upon the Lord, they shall have their strength renewed. And the Lord is going to renew our strength, even in this time of stress. In these challenging times and difficult time, God is going to bring opportunity our way. And these opportunities will make us better. We will be better people after this challenge. Because I believe even those who do not pray, now they will take time to pray. Even those who do not think about God, they will have some time to think about God. Those who depend so much on their strength, they will know at a certain point in time, they need God, not their strength. Those who depend on their wisdom, even sometimes their knowledge comes to the end, they will need God. And you can see now the world is crying for God's mercy. And therefore, we should look unto God and not worry, because worry will not add a cubit of our stature. Worry will only destroy our emotion. We become anxious and we become confused. But it is time for us to turn to God and to ask God to guide us and to lead us. And the Bible continues to say that we seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and these other things shall be added unto us. It is time for us to seek God. And when we seek God, even in this situation, God is going to intervene. And I want to say it again. The Lord is in control, even at this point in time, when there is so much stress, when the economy is so much stressed, when the government is so much worried, when the world is so much worried. God, who is the creator of heaven and earth, is in control. And after this, we shall know him better. And therefore, the report that we are hearing, they should not destroy us, but they should make us. Do not be destroyed by this report. I would even encourage you, even to take time to read the word of God at this time, more than even listening to the TV and the radios. Because the reports that we are going to get there, they are not going to be encouraging. But I want to tell us, there is the report that is coming from heaven, that it shall be well with us. It is for you to ask yourself, which report are you going to believe? Believe the report of the Lord that says, it shall be well with us. It shall be well with the righteous. And the Bible continues to say that if my people that are called by my name, they shall humble themselves and pray, repent their sins, God will come, will hear their prayers, he will heal their land, because God is going to heal us, is going to heal our land. And because we are called by his name, and we are going to be better people even after this challenge. So let us be encouraged, and let us even believe the reports of the Lord, that it shall be well with the righteous. It shall be well with our country. Our country is a God-fearing country. We thank God because of the president and his deputy, because they agreed to humble themselves and they called us to prayer. And we are praying, and the Lord is going to heal our land. It shall be well. Our economy will stand. Our children will go back to class. Yes, we shall go back to our places of work. Our business will rise up again. We shall be stronger than we were stronger there before. And therefore, let's wait upon the Lord, because the Lord is coming. The only thing that we need to do is to take our time to read the word of God, take a time to pray and to remind God of his promises, take time to humble ourselves and to realize that we can do nothing without God. Let's take a time and go back to God. And if you have never given your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, it is important for you to know you need God more than anything else. You need God more than money. You need God more than the wealth that you look for so much. You need God more than power. You need God more than prestige. You need God more than whatever you look for every day, because God has the solution to every prayer, every problem in life. And therefore, as the Bible says, seek first the kingdom of God, and these things shall be added unto you. And to conclude, the Bible concludes by saying, therefore do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow we will worry about its own. Sufficient for the day is its own trouble. Do not worry. May the peace of God be your portion in Jesus' name. Let me pray for you as we conclude. Our Father, in the name of Jesus, we are living in a very anxious movement. And Jehovah God, sometimes we come to the end of our thinking. But you understand the situation that we are in. We want to thank you specifically because of the gift of life, because of the breath of life. Sometimes we take it for granted that we are breathing. And this corona has shown us that there are times that we can even stop breathing, even if there is a lot of air. Sometimes we take our life for granted and we think it is automatic to live. But Father, as we receive this wake-up call, we pray that you may help us to come back to ourselves like the prodigal son, and we come back to the Father. And we thank you because you are in control. We thank you because you are telling us it shall be well. Help us to trust you. Help us to wait upon you. Help us to seek to know what you are telling us, even in these difficult circumstances. Heal our emotions. Contain our emotions. Protect our families. Protect our nation. Protect our government. Protect our economy, we pray. We pray that Jehovah help us to listen to you, to what you are telling us. We thank and we give you praise. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Be comforted.